I'm in Toronto, Canada, and Toronto is cold for a lot of the year. Good winter boots are a necessity. They've got to be warm, they've got to be waterproof, but also, they've got to stop you going arse over apex when you suddenly walk on a patch of ice. This is WinterLab, and it's part of the Challenging Environment Assessment Laboratories at the Toronto Rehabilitation Institute, and this is their tilting frozen floor.
If you want to find out whether people are at risk of falling, at risk of a road accident, at risk of something, you need to put them in a challenging environment and see how they respond. What we have is four modules for different things. We have the world's actually most realistic driving simulator now. When it rains in our simulator, it actually rains. We also have Stair Lab, where we have people walk up and down stairs, and we suddenly and unexpectedly move the room, and they have to grab the handrails, and we can see how effective the handrails are or the stair design. 21,000 people in Ontario every winter, on average, end up in our emergency rooms because they've fallen on ice and snow. So the purpose of WinterLab is so that we can do two things. One is that we can test the boots and inform consumers what they should buy, and the other is we can help companies and ourselves develop better boots.
I know I'm harnessed in, but that is terrifying.
It's an ice box, really. It's insulated. We can generate winds. We can actually make nice, white, fluffy snow. We can control the air temperature very precisely, and we can control the temperature of the ice very precisely. We actually have a group of graduate students, like every other university lab you've ever been to, because they're not very expensive and they're sort of disposable, who do this testing. Because we want sort of uniformity.
It's a good harness, very good harness.
Now, in order to test the performance of shoes, we choose to put WinterLab on top of a platform that we can gradually tip.
It does feel ever so slightly like gravity is shifting.
We tip it as you walk up and down until the moment that you slip. We have an angle which we think is just acceptable. It's 7 degrees. We actually take the minimum value of several people. If you can make 7 degrees up and down confidently, we give you one snowflake.
This is the good shoes. I can just... Oh, okay, yeah. No, I can literally just walk normally.
At the moment, we've got a scale of 3 snowflakes. And that was because the first time we ever did this, 90 out of 100 boots failed to get 1 snowflake, and nothing got better than 1 snowflake. So to publish it as a 5 snowflake scale looked a bit depressing. We've already tested some prototypes for next year, and they're getting 2 and 3 snowflakes.
But that's fine. I put my foot down, it just stays where it is.
We are really quite confident that eventually we're going to be able to add some more snowflakes at the 4 and 5 level. It raises another interesting point, and that is, can you have too much friction? We're a long way off that yet, but of course, more than half the falls that you experience are people tripping up. We will eventually decide whether a 5 snowflake shoe is a good idea or not. I'm really happy. In 2 years, we've done 2 things. One is that we've changed the buying habits of people, and the other is now the industry is improving the quality of boots, and we're helping them do that.
Thank you very much to all the team at WinterLab here at the Toronto Rehabilitation Institute. Pull down the links in the description for more about them and their research. I swear I'm not deliberately trying to do that.